substitute global market. But from a US perspective, they have a very, very poor jobs number, 38,000 jobs added in the market of May. That was 120,000 less than the market would be expected to see stopped any efforts for a short-term rate increase.
Let me ask you, as a currency specialist, we had a significant weakness in sterling yesterday with more polls putting lead in front, but it wasn't in free fall, was it?
Well, I think there's still a lot of betting out there on the result to come. I think a lot of speculators out there are sat there going, we can't really trust these polls. We don't really know what's going on. For every one poll that says the Leave camp has a 7% lead, there's a Congress poll, for example, over 9% the Remain camp having a 1% lead. No one really knows what the betting is. And the last thing anybody really wants to do is hold the wrong side of this. See a 5, 6, 10% move on these debts. So I think a lot of money's been taken out of these markets, and all being sat on the sidelines, which would be a more clear indication of how they're going to actually play.
Perhaps not as much money coming out as you might expect, and all big investors that I've spoken to have said follow the money and don't follow the polls, but is there an argument that perhaps a lot of that money just isn't that smart? Because we've got George Soros coming out of retirement and saying that he's going to start putting all this money in gold, so are a lot of these investors going to get blindsided by the fallout of the Leave results?
I think there's a lot of opportunity within these markets at the moment, depending on which way you think the vote is going to go. And I think a lot of people will hold off until it becomes very, very clear. And then throw the kitchen sink at it. There's a lot of reason for sterling to fall on the back of a Brexit, the current account scenario that we have here in the UK, the funding that we need, the broader fiscal deficit that we have here in the UK, the credit picture, the impact of the Bank of England, the cost of easing, all lend itself to a lower pound. I think a lot of people, every investment bank out there that I've spoken to is talking about a lower pound as a result of the Brexit. So once that's confirmed, maybe that's when we'll really see the market.
Just very briefly, could we get an intervention to support sterling if there is a big, big sell-off? Just very briefly.
Yeah, I think the Bank of England will have to step in on that Friday if we do see a big, big sell-off. Trying to get liquidity into the market, trying to make sure the trade is orderly, but maybe not to prevent it from falling.
Okay, Jeremy, very good to talk to you. Thank you very much. That is all for me. Let's go back to Kate. A big thank you very much. Quick look at what's happening as far as the weather's concerned. Continues to be miserable. England, Wales and Ireland will be the heavy and sometimes torrential and thundery showers for the rest of the afternoon. Although North East England will be the main lead driver as well. Scotland will remain largely overcast without breaks of rain. Showers in the south will be concentrated over central and southern Ireland, Wales and southwest and central England. More scattered in the south east. In some places they're staying dry and quite sunny. Elsewhere, Northern Ireland will be mainly fine in the evening, but Scotland will see more rain, heaviest. The question we're going to be asking in our debate coming up in the next hour here on Sky News relates to this blue-on-blue action that we've seen as a result of the EU referendum debate. And the question that we're going to be asking you, see on Twitter as well, is whether or not the Tory leadership can survive this brutal EU referendum battle. We've seen that dozens of Conservative MPs have already signed a letter to say that they will rebel against the Chancellor's emergency budget should we see one come Brexit. Do you have a thought on that? Dan Hodges is with us. Alex Beam as well. In just a moment.
There is a sign for perfectionism. There's a sign for goosebumps. Something that symbolizes more performance. A sign for special mindset. There is a sign for everything we stand for. Audi Sport. 400.